बच्चियो जे असी अपने आले दुआले वेखिए ता सानू वक वक किस्मा दे सजीव वेखन नू मिलनगे। इना सजीवा विच पौधे अते जानवर दोवे शामल हुंदे हन। इना विचो कुछ छोटे पौधे हुंदे हन अते कुछ वड्डे। कुछ पौधे गमलिया विच भी वध सकदे हन जदकि कुछ वद्दे दरख्त दे रूप विच जमीन विच वद्दे हन। कुछ सजीव धरती दी सतह ते पनपदे हन अते कुछ पानी विच। इन्ना विचो कुछ केवल सुखम दर्शी राही ही वेखे जा सकदे हन अते दूजियां नू असी अपनियां नंगियां अखां राही वेख सकदे हां। इन्ना सारे सजीवां लई एक गल आम है कि ए सारे सजीव विकास करदे हन अते एक निश्चित समय बाद खत्म हो जांदे हन। इस संसार विच कोई भी अजिहा सजीव नहीं है जो कि हमेशा जिउंदा रहिंदा है, पर इस संसार नू छड्डन तो पहला ओ अपनियां जातियां नू जां वंश नू जारी रखन दा उपराला कर जांदे हन। इन नटशेल, रिप्रोडक्शन इज द क्रिएशन ऑफ अ न्यू इंडिविजुअल और इंडिविजुअल्स फ्रॉम एग्जिस्टिंग इंडिविजुअल्स। रिप्रोडक्शन गिव्स राइज टू न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म विद द सेम बेसिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एज देयर पेरेंट्स। पंपकिन सीड्स विल ऑलवेज प्रोड्यूस पंपकिन प्लांट एंड कैट्स विल ऑलवेज प्रोड्यूस किटन्स नॉट पप्स। The process of giving rise to new organism can occur in two primary ways, through asexual reproduction and through sexual reproduction. In our today's class, let's look at various modes of asexual reproduction.
Students, welcome to today's lesson about asexual reproduction. Reproduction enables a species to live generation after generation. As you know, the known methods of reproduction are broadly grouped into two main types, asexual and sexual reproduction. Sajeev, jo sexually reproduction karde han, bahut ghat ginti vich offspring paida karde han, par inna de genes vich bahut sariyan vibhinnatawan paiyan jandiyan han, jo ki inna nu rogan ਅਤੇ ਬਦਲਦੇ ਵਾਤਾਵਰਨ ਦਾ ਮੁਕਾਬਲਾ ਕਰਨ ਯੋਗ ਬਣਾਉਂਦੀਆਂ ਹਨ। ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਅਗਲੀਆਂ ਕਲਾਸਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਸੈਕਸ਼ੂਅਲ ਰੀਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵੱਖ-ਵੱਖ ਪੱਖਾਂ ਬਾਰੇ ਪੜ੍ਹਾਂਗੇ, ਪਰ ਅੱਜ ਦੀ ਇਸ ਕਲਾਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ
ਆਪਣਾ ਧਿਆਨ
ਏਸੈਕਸ਼ੂਅਲ ਰੀਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਸ਼ਨ ਤੇ ਕੇਂਦਰਿਤ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਇਨ ਏਸੈਕਸ਼ੂਅਲ ਰੀਪ੍ਰੋਡਕਸ਼ਨ ਆਫਸਪ੍ਰਿੰਗ ਪ੍ਰੋਡਿਊਸਡ ਆਰ ਜੈਨੇਟਿਕਲੀ ਆਈਡੈਂਟੀਕਲ ਟੂ ਇਟਸ ਪੇਰੈਂਟਸ, ਦੇਅਰਫੋਰ ਥੀਸ ਆਫਸਪ੍ਰਿੰਗਸ ਆਰ ਰੈਫਰਡ ਐਸ ਕਲੋਨਸ। Asexual reproduction is very common in microorganisms, but there are also many plants that use asexual methods of reproduction in nature. Different modes of asexual reproduction in various plants and animals will be discussed in our today's topic. But before that, let me share the learning objectives for today's lesson.
On completion of this topic, learners will be able to discuss importance of reproduction in the life of living organisms, define asexual reproduction, compare asexual reproduction with sexual reproduction, describe different modes of asexual reproduction, give examples of organisms exhibiting different modes of reproduction.
Asexual reproduction is a mode of reproduction which does not require meiotic type of cell division as well as complicated process like fertilization. In this mode of reproduction, development of an organism takes place from non-sexual reproductive parts like buds, fragments, some specific cells of the body, etc. Asexual reproduction does not require two parents and special cells like sperm and ova. So asexual reproduction takes place without the fusion of gametes. This process requires less energy and allows rapid expansion of the species. Sadharan sajeev, jive amoeba, bacteria, ikkale asexual reproduction kar sakde han, par bahut sare hor sajeev apne life cycle di zarurat de anusar dove tarah de methods jive asexual and sexual methods nu apnaunde han. Try to think of some animals that reproduce asexually. Here are some. Let me check how many of them you can identify. There are several types of asexual reproduction happening in different types of organisms. A variety of ways are adopted by various organisms to reproduce asexually. Many protozoa, such as Eugalina, amoeba, paramecium, etc., undergo binary fission, in which a single-celled organism divides evenly into two identical cells. Others, such as trypanosoma, which causes African sleeping sickness, undergoes multiple fission, involving repeated nuclear division before splitting into many daughter cells. Kuch sajeev, single parent to outgrowth ja bad rahi paida hunde han. Sajeeva diya bahut sariya kisma ek fragment to ek whole individual generate karan which capable hundiyan han, jive flatworms, sea anemones, green algae adi. Let us list the main modes of asexual reproduction in animals, especially in microorganisms. These are fission, budding, fragmentation, zoospore formation, etc. We will discuss all these one by one. Let's start with fission. In this type of asexual reproduction, a fully grown parental organism divides into two or more daughter cells. This means a whole parental body acts as a reproductive unit. Fission is of two types, depending upon the number of daughter cells produced: binary fission and multiple fission. Binary fission, where a parental body divides into two cells. Multiple fission, where a parental body divides into many daughter cells. Binary fission is the simplest and most common method of asexual reproduction found in protists, bacteria, algae, flatworms, etc. Binary fission starts with karyokinesis, means the division of nucleus, followed by cytokinesis, means the division of cytoplasm. Every time, all daughter cells contain an exact copy of the genetic information which was present in the parent cell. On the basis of planes through which a parental body divides, binary fission is also of three types. Let's quickly see all these three types of binary fission. Observe carefully.
Irregular or simple binary fission. This is a very simple and orthodox type of cell division in which plane of division is difficult to observe. This is amoeba, one of the simplest living animals consisting of a single cell. It belongs to protozoa group. It lives in muddy water, in soil, and as parasites on body parts of some animals. An amoeba moves by changing its body shape, forming extensions called pseudopodia. Its body consists of colorless protoplasm. Its activities are controlled by the nucleus, and it feeds by engulfing organic debris. Just before division, it takes round shape and its contractile vacuole disappears. This is the nucleus. Here, the nuclear material present in amoeba first replicates, means get doubled. Nucleus disintegrates to form two nuclei. Now this semi-fluid substance known as cytoplasm starts dividing. Soon this single-celled amoeba divides into two cells. These two cells thus formed are known as daughter cells.
So, organisms like amoeba are immortal because each new formed cell has complete material from the parent cell. Cytokinesis, that is, division of cytoplasm, may take place along any plane, but it is always perpendicular to that of karyokinesis, that is, division of nucleus. Let's observe the intricacies of another type of binary fission, that is, longitudinal binary fission.
This is euglena, a one-celled organism, the shape of which can change very quickly, enabling it to move around. It moves with the help of a single flagellum. This animation shows the euglena dividing into two new organisms by splitting down the middle along the longitudinal axis. The nucleus, chloroplast, and basal bodies all divide, so each new cell ends up with the required cell components. This way, two daughter cells are formed.
In the process of longitudinal binary fission, the plane of constriction is along the longitudinal axis of the animal body. Euglena is different from other protozoa because it has chlorophyll in it, the substance that plants contain to make their own food. There is another type of binary fission which involves division through transverse axis. This video will make it more clear. Let's see how it happens.
Transverse binary fission. This is paramecium, an important component of food chain. It consumes bacteria and in turn consumed by microscopic invertebrates and larger species. In this organism, binary fission initiates by forming constriction on the cell surface. Micronucleus as well as macronucleus start dividing along with the constriction of cell surface. Gradually, a transverse wall is formed, dividing the parent cell in two daughter cells. These two cells separate and each behaves as individual paramecium.
ਸੋ ਹੁਣੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਪੈਰਾਮੀਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਵੇਖਿਆ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਸਵਰਸਲੀ ਦੋ ਡਾਟਰ ਸੈਲਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਡਿਵਾਈਡ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਬਾਇਨਰੀ ਫਿਸ਼ਨ ਲੌਂਗੀਟਿਊਡਨਲ ਜਾਂ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਸਵਰਸ ਮੈਥਡ ਨਾਲ ਹੋਵੇ ਹਰ ਵਾਰੀ ਪੇਰੈਂਟ ਸੈੱਲ ਦੋ ਡਾਟਰ ਸੈਲਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੀ ਵੰਡਿਆ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅਨਦਰ ਟਾਈਪ ਆਫ ਫਿਸ਼ਨ ਵੇਅਰ ਦਾ ਪੇਰੈਂਟਲ ਬਾਡੀ ਡਿਵਾਈਡਸ ਇੰਟੂ ਮੈਨੀ ਡਾਟਰ ਸੈਲਸ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਕਾਮਨ ਇਨ ਸਪੋਰੋਜ਼ੋਨਸ Radiolaria, Foraminifera, and Mastigophora. Let's see this type of fission happening in one of the sporozoans. In multiple fission, nucleus of a parental body divides into many daughter cells. In Plasmodium, the nucleus divides repeatedly by mitosis and the individual becomes a multinucleated organism. These newly formed nuclei migrate towards the periphery and get surrounded by the fragments of cytoplasm. They become free when parental body ruptures. The number of offsprings thus produced is highly variable and sometimes reaches up to thousands. The multiple fission occurs at different phases of life cycle in different individuals, and the phases are named accordingly: cyzygony,
gamogony
and sporogony.
Cyzygony. The term is used when multiple fission occurs somewhere in an asexual cycle of an organism's life. The resulting individuals are known as cyzons, develop directly into the adults. For example, Plasmodium. Gamogony. When multiple fission produces sex cells, it is termed as gamogony, and the products of such fission are male or female gametes. These gametes further take part in sexual reproduction. For example, monocystis. Sporogony. Here, the multiple fission usually takes place in zygote-like structure called oocyst, where the sex cells, known as spores, are liberated. These spores, under favorable conditions, grow into complete organism. For example, Plasmodium.
There is another type of fission known as plasmotomy, where a multinucleate adult parent undergoes cytokinesis to form many multinucleate daughter cells without the division of nuclei. Means, plasmotomy is a type of asexual reproduction in which a multinucleate protozoan cell divides into two or more multinucleate daughter cells without the role of mitosis. So this was all about fission. Now let's learn something about another very simple method of asexual reproduction, budding. It is a method of reproduction in which a new organism is formed in the form of a bud. A bud can be present inside the body or outside the body. When it is present inside the body, it is known as
endogenous.
And when the bud is present outside the body, it is known as
exogenous.
Here are the examples of exogenous buds taking the shape of independent individuals.
This is Hydra. Its body is shaped like a thin cylinder with several tentacles extending from the mouth. During budding, Hydra simply forms a bud on the side of its body. The rate of growth of bud is controlled by the food present in the surroundings. The young Hydra develops tentacles and then breaks off, fully prepared to exist in its own. Buds are produced every 2 to 3 days under favorable conditions. See another example of budding. This is a yeast cell, which is used in baking and brewing. Here, a small bud or daughter cell is formed on the parent cell. The nucleus of the parent cell splits into a daughter nucleus and migrates into the daughter cells or bud. This bud or newly formed daughter cell continues to grow until it separates from the parent cell, forming a new cell. Many buds may start growing at a time. Soon, they break away and take up an independent existence.
These both were the examples of
exogenous budding.
In some organisms, these buds are formed inside the body and the process is known as
endogenous budding.
Like in sponges, they reproduce asexually by releasing clusters of cells called gemmules. They are surrounded by unique
spicules,
gemmules of undifferentiated cells called archaeocytes, enclosed by a protective coat. During favorable conditions, these archaeocytes come out of gemmule through a micropyle and form a new sponge. Unlike the binary fission, the identity of the parent body is retained after reproduction in budding. Means, in binary fission, the complete parent cell divides to form two new cells, whereas in budding we saw one parent cell or organism keeps on producing many buds without losing own existence. Next is fragmentation. In the organisms which show fragmentation, the power of regeneration is very high. In this type of reproduction, from any cut portion, the whole organism will regenerate. This is very common in some flatworms, sea anemones, echinoderms, etc. The ability of regeneration depends upon the complexity of organism. An interesting modification of fragmentation is regeneration. Let's see how it all happens.
This is planaria, which is a little half-inch flatworm. Due to some mechanical shock, it breaks into pieces. Each of these fragments develops into a mature worm, and the process is repeated. It can be cut into as many as 32 pieces, and each fragment will be able to rebuild a miniature flatworm complete with head, tail, eyes, mouth, and internal organs. Another example of asexual reproduction is the fragmentation of starfish. Here we can see, if a part of an arm of this starfish breaks off, it not only regenerates the arm, but the broken piece of this arm also grows into an entire organism.
Zoospore. A zoospore is a motile asexual spore. Some members of kingdom fungi and algae reproduce by forming the special asexual structure known as zoospore. This zoospore is a flagellated motile structure which is produced in zoosporangium. These are the zoospores of various algae. Just watch them carefully. During favorable conditions, they come out of their zoosporangium and grow into complete filamentous bodies. Whatever we discussed till now, all were the examples of asexual reproduction. If we compare asexual reproduction with sexual reproduction involves the production of new organism by the fusion of male and female gametes. These gametes fuse to form zygote, which develop to produce a genetically different organism. Asexual reproduction, on the other hand, is the production of new cells by simple division of a parent cell. Since there is no fusion of cells from different individuals, the daughter cells produced by asexual reproduction are genetically identical to the parent cell. One major advantage of asexual reproduction is that organism can reproduce rapidly within a very short period. Aao, hun ek related term vegetative propagation nu discuss kar laiye. The process of producing plants asexually is called vegetative propagation. In vegetative propagation, a portion or fragment of the plant body functions as propagate, means agge vadhana. Thus, it develops into a new individual. Kai ajehe paude vi han jo sirf alingi prajanan yani asexually propagate karde han. Kuch paudeyan nu beejan rahi ugauna mushkil hunda hai ate inna paudeyan di paidawar nu sambhav banaun layi asexual reproduction method hi kargar sidh hunda hai. ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਹੋ ਕਿ ਪੋਟੇਟੋਸ, ਬਨਾਨਾਸ, ਜਿੰਜਰ ਦੀ ਖੇਤੀ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ? ਆਓ ਵੇਖੀਏ।
ਫਾਰਮਰਸ ਗਰੋ ਪੋਟੇਟੋਸ ਬਾਈ ਪਲਾਂਟਿੰਗ ਦੀ ਆਈਜ਼ ਆਫ ਪੋਟੇਟੋਸ ਟੂ ਪ੍ਰੋਡਿਊਸ ਮੋਰ ਪੋਟੇਟੋ ਪਲਾਂਟਸ। ਦੀਸ ਆਈਜ਼ ਆਰ ਬੇਸਿਕਲੀ ਬਰਡਸ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਟ ਇਨ ਦੀ ਐਗਜ਼ਿਲਸ ਆਫ ਸਕਾਰਸ ਆਫ ਸਕੇਲ ਲੀਵਸ। These eyes-like structures represent the nodes of an ordinary stem. In banana plants, the suckers that grow from the root of the plant are separated. These suckers are grown to plants as new ones. In case of ginger, they have nodes and internodes. Thin, dry, brownish, papery scale leaves are present on the nodes. Axillary buds are also present on the nodes. When the conditions are favorable, the buds grow into aerial shoots to form new plants. In many plants, subaerial stems develop adventitious buds, which on getting detached from the plant body develop into new shoots. Runners are also horizontal stems growing from the parent plant, but they grow above ground. In mint, when their terminal buds touch the ground, they form roots and produce new plants. Plants such as the strawberry has a very short stem called a rootstock with thin scale leaves. In this, the branches bend and get covered with soil, then grow into a separate plant.
Students, do you know that commercially important plants are often deliberately grown by asexual means in order to keep some desirable traits? Mainly, all plant organs have been used for vegetative propagation, that is, asexual reproduction, but stems are the most common. I think today we have learnt enough about asexual reproduction in plants and animals. Let us now summarize what have we learned so far. Larger animals tend to reproduce sexually and smaller organisms reproduce asexually. In asexual reproduction, there is only one parent. The young is an exact copy of the parent. Organisms that reproduce asexually cannot develop much variety because they are the copies of the original organism almost exactly. The young is a clone of the parent. Most unicellular organisms reproduce asexually. For example, an amoeba reproduces by dividing itself into two cells. Some multicellular organisms also reproduce asexually. Hydra and sea anemone reproduce by growing buds. Some plants also reproduce asexually. Selective advantage of asexual reproduction is that the organism can reproduce without finding a partner. The disadvantage of asexual reproduction is that genetic variability decreases and the population is less able to survive changes in the environment. Some species use the advantages of both asexual and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction produces clones, that is, offsprings completely identical to the parent. If a starfish is cut into 5 pieces, each arm can regenerate an entire starfish, although a few animals can regenerate in this fashion. When plants reproduce asexually, it is known as vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is the ability of plants to reproduce without sexual reproduction by producing new plants from existing vegetative structures. Plants have a number of mechanisms for asexual reproduction. We discussed many examples of vegetative propagation in various plants. Because asexual reproduction does not require the formation of gametes, it occurs much faster than sexual reproduction and requires less energy. So now we come to the end of today's topic. Here's a quick test for you to find out how much you have actually absorbed. Question: Name the mode of reproduction where only one parent is required. And the answer is, only one parent is required in asexual reproduction. My next question to you is, name the type of asexual reproduction where a fully grown parental organism divides into two or more daughter cells. Well, the answer is, this type of asexual reproduction is known as fission. Next question. Name one organism in which asexual reproduction takes place along longitudinal axis. Well, the answer is, in Eugelina, asexual reproduction along longitudinal axis takes place. My next question to you is, what type of fission takes place in paramecium? The answer is, in paramecium, transverse binary fission takes place. Another question to you is, name the term where a multinucleate adult undergoes cytokinesis to form multinucleate daughter cells. The answer to this question is, this term is known as plasmatomy. Another question which I'll be asking you is, name the term which is used for multiple fission of
encysted
oocysts. Answer: It is known as sporogony. My next question is, name one organism where budding takes place inside the parental body. The answer to this question is, a freshwater sponge is an organism in which budding takes place inside the parental body. Another question is, name the process through which body fragments develop into complete organism. The answer is regeneration. My next question is, what is vegetative propagation? Answer: Vegetative propagation is the ability of plants to reproduce without sexual reproduction. My next question is, can you tell me how banana is grown? Answer: In banana plants, the suckers that grow from the root of the plant are used to raise new plant. My next question is there any advantage of asexual reproduction? Well, the answer is, one major advantage of asexual reproduction is that organisms can reproduce rapidly within a very short period. I'm confident that you have all scored well. I hope you enjoyed the lesson as much as I did, and looking forward to the next class. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.